are the planets big and round. Watch us happily fly.
What? Pluto is not a planet. Hey, my name is Khadija Bushareb and I will be explaining why Pluto is no longer considered as a planet. Our solar system is one of over 500 in the Milky Way galaxy. It came to be 4.5 billion years ago. Only 15% of its stars host planets. One of these stars is our Sun. In 1930, the American astronomer Clyde Tombaugh was patiently scanning photographic plates at the Lowell Observatory, where he found a tiny speck that he announced it as a planet, called Pluto. It's named by Venetia Burney and it refers to the god of the underworld. In 1978, astronomers James Christie and Robert Harrington found out that Pluto had actually a moon, called Charon. Some consider Pluto and Charon as the first binary system known in our solar system, because the very center of their orbit does not lie on either body. Pluto and Charon together would barely stretch across the continental United States. Pluto is the most distant from the Sun, which makes the distance between the Sun and Pluto is equal to 40 times the distance between the Sun and the Earth, which makes one round of Pluto around the Sun is equal to 248 years. Pluto sometimes behaves like a comet more than a planet when its eccentric orbit brings it closer to the Sun. Its surface heats up, which creates a denser atmosphere. Right after 1992, Pluto's status as a planet was questioned, following the discovery of several objects similar to Pluto in the Kuiper Belt. NASA sent a spacecraft called New Horizons on a 9-year voyage, aiming to revolutionize our understanding to the cosmic neighborhood. In August 2006, the International Astronomical Union, IAU, reclassified Pluto, Charon, and Eris as dwarf planets. So they defined the word planet formally. A planet should meet these three criteria. It should be orbiting the Sun, has sufficient mass to assume its hydrostatic equilibrium, which means it has to be nearly round, and it must be gravitationally dominant to clear its orbit from debris. But Pluto fails to meet the third condition. Therefore, the definition of a dwarf planet was set as a celestial body in direct orbit of the Sun that's massive enough that its shape is controlled by gravitational forces rather than mechanical forces, and is thus ellipsoid in shape, but has not cleared its neighboring region of other objects. Yet, there has been some resistance within the astronomical community toward the reclassification. Alan Stern, principal investigator with NASA's New Horizons mission, derided the IAU resolution, contending that by the terms of the new definition of a planet, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, and Neptune would be excluded, all of which share their orbits with asteroids. Well, science is always evolving, and who knows what's coming up next?